Hello! Welcome to this video. Let's get a complete overview on the amazing Apple Evernote through simple and quick steps. Please write comments inside the video description to give us feedback and tips for our future video guides for Mac software. Apple Evernote is used to create notes quickly, complete with files and attachments, in order to store and access them across several devices online, such as laptops, tablets, and smartphones, or to share them with friends and colleagues. These features make Evernote perfect to organize business jobs or your own personal homework. Evernote comes with several plans, divided into Basic, Plus, Premium, and Business. In this video, we will see just the basic version, which is free and does not require any subscription, including most of the features inside Evernote. Other plans allow bigger storage size, customer support, offline access, and other extra features we will see. To start using Evernote, you need to sign in with your account with email and password. If you don't have it, you can create a new one quickly under Create Account. And then verify your email address. Once done, Evernote opens with its interface, with the main black panel on the left and the selected content on the right. Evernote works with the notes, which are objects containing text, media files, and any kind of attachment. To see how to use this software, let's just start with a new note by clicking on New Note on top. This shows up on the right panel, where you can start typing. Set up a title on top and type the content at the bottom. Right above, you can manage and adjust the properties for the text, such as font family, size, style, and color, or apply any highlighter. Consider that the new settings affect either the new text or any text that is selected inside your note. Moreover, you can find additional font styles for your selected text by right-clicking on it and going to Format. In case you add hyperlinks, Evernote recognizes them and these become clickable, allowing a direct visit online. In addition, you have advanced tools to organize the content of your note. For example, you can create bullet and numbered lists on each new line, or use the third button to make to-do lists with interactive squares for each task you have to complete. The fourth button is used to divide the note into several sections by extending simple horizontal lines. You can also adjust the text distribution by using the paragraph buttons. Inside the note, you can also add tables by using the table button, choosing the number of rows and columns. Then, click on each cell to type inside, adjusting the text properties on top. To add other rows or columns, you can click on the gray nodes around the table. To manage the cell's size, just click and move from their own edges. You can also color each cell by clicking on the arrow inside it and choosing the color you like most. If you need to color the entire rows, columns, or the whole table, just click and hold on the interested cells to select them before adding colors. The same arrow is used either to merge the selected cells or to remove the entire row, column, or table selected. Notes can also collect files as attachments, including media files, such as sound, pictures, and videos. you can import one inside your note by dragging and dropping it inside. Depending on the kind of file, this is shown inside your note in a different way. Most of these files are shown within a rectangular contour, complete with the file name, size, and two buttons on the right. Quick Look is used to open, check, and edit the file. Whereas Save As is used to download the file in your Mac, useful in case you are reading the note from another device or email. In case of audio files, the Play button is used to play back the file content through the player that shows at the top. Images and pictures are opened directly inside the note. Click on it to select it. At this point, you can click once again to preview the picture. Or drag from the blue node at the bottom to size the image. When you import presentations or PDF documents, Evernote shows a complete preview of each page. In case of PDF files, you also get the Annotate button to add notes, arrows, and comments inside the document. Pay attention that this feature is available only through a 30-day trial period. Then it becomes part of the premium plan. Moreover, with a basic plan, you can't get notes over 25 megabytes in size each. You may need to upgrade to store and save bigger notes. All these tables and attached files are always in line with the text. You can click and drag these objects to move them within the note, from one line to another. You can also remove them as you do with simple text by using the backspace key. Use Command and X, Command and C, and Command and V to cut, copy, or paste selected text or objects inside your note. If you make a mistake, use Command and Z to undo your latest actions. Besides the text properties, you also have advanced tools right on top of your note. Use Record Audio to start recording external sound with your Mac. Use Take Snapshot to take a photo from your webcam or browse for a default picture available. Use Attach File to search and import files from your Mac folders, and Attach File from Google Drive to add files from your Google Drive account. As you type inside your note, this automatically saved and synced online. In particular, every time you see the sync button enabled. As soon as the sync finishes, the latest version of your note is stored online to be downloaded by any device or user. In the top right corner, you get other advanced options for your note. Click on the first button to add reminders in order to receive notifications when the deadline is near. Whereas, use Note Info to check and edit the metadata of your note, such as title, dates, location, and authors. Use the Bin button to move the note into the trash. The trash section collects all the discarded notes, which can be restored on Evernote or deleted forever. Consider that you won't be able to edit any note inside the trash until you restore it first. As long as you write and sync your note, this will be available online, but is not shared with anyone yet. To start sharing, click on the Share button in the top right corner and enter the email address of the receiver and his permissions rules with such file, such as inviting, editing, or just reading. At the bottom, under Members, you can check the list of all the people sharing or editing the note. You can also choose to share the note by copying and pasting a hyperlink as it is, or via social websites through the right button. In this way, all the people with the link can consult your note without a direct invitation. Other features, such as the presentation mode and the annotations, are available only through a premium account, and include the ability to open your note as a ready presentation, or transform it into a PDF file complete with comments and annotations. As you create notes inside Evernote, all of them are listed on the left side, under All Notes. You can change the way to check and browse for your notes with the View Options button. The default one used is called Card View. Evernote allows to organize your notes efficiently, especially when you start getting lots of them. You can either use the shortcuts, the notebooks, or the tags. Shortcuts is a personal section placed on the left panel that lists all the notes you have dropped inside. This is perfect in case you are working on the same notes and you want to pick them up quickly. Notebooks are folders collecting several notes, just like sheets of paper inside a workbook. By default, you have a notebook plus the trash section, but you can create others by going to New Notebook on top, defining a name and its privacy settings, which can be either private or shared online. At this point, you can double-click on a notebook to check its content inside. Or you can select the notebook directly from the All Notes list. Pay attention that each note can be collected inside one single notebook. You can change its notebook by clicking on the notebook name at the top of the note and choosing from the list. To manage, rename, and delete your notebook, just right-click on it. Consider that you can't restore any notebook deleted, but retrieve all of its notes inside the trash section. To share an entire notebook online, just use the Share button and insert the email addresses. To share it with a simple hyperlink, just use the down arrow and then go to Publish Notebook. Also, tags are used to organize your notes. These are custom keywords related to the content of your note. On top of your note, next to its notebook, you can type all the tags separated by a comma. When you go to the Tags section on the left, you can double-click on one tag to open the list with all the notes matching such keyword. If you are not able to find your note, you search for it by using the Search Notes bar at the very top. This looks for anything matching your keywords inside the notes, notebooks, and tags. In case you have a device that does not have Evernote, you can retrieve all your notes and notebooks by logging in evernote.com. Its interface may change a little, but all the basic features are exactly the same. Evernote is also a great software to get quick notes and screenshots while working with your Mac. When Evernote is open, its elephant icon appears on the top Mac bar. If you click on it, you get a small window where you can directly type a new note and make some quick, useful operations, such as taking a snapshot to your whole screen with Clip Full Screen, or to a selected region with Clip Rectangle. Use the third button to start recording audio with your microphone. In case you are going to share your notes inside a team, you can directly chat with your members by using the Work Chat in the bottom left corner, providing their email addresses. These are all the amazing features inside Apple Evernote Basic. Feel free to check out our YouTube channel for more amazing and outstanding video guides for your Mac software.